You know, I say that we must think about things as systems, complex, interconnected systems. In fact, I call them complex socio-technical systems. Societal, technical. We need society, we need technology, and their systems, socio-technical systems. These are hard to understand, really hard to understand. And it's because actually the human mind isn't designed to understand the complexities of all these systems. Look at climate change as a good example of something that is really difficult for people to grasp, but there are some simple psychological reasons why it's so difficult. One is, we're used to causality. We're sort of designed evolutionarily that we look for simple causes for the reason, and we understand the results. And, you know, if I throw a rock and it hits something, well, the cause was my throwing of the rock. And when it hit something, the thing broke or something happened, and I can see exactly what I did and what the result was and the causal impact. But that isn't how the world often works. So lots of systems take time. So that the feedback, which is when I do something, I see the result, and that feeds back to my knowledge system, and I say, oh, I was effective. Or maybe I'm trying to throw a rock to hit a target or shoot a ball into a basket. I can do it, and when I miss, I can say, oh, I went to the left too much. Let me try it again going to the right. Oh, I wasn't high enough. Let me try going higher. Oh, I didn't do this. I didn't do that. You can improve yourself because you can immediately see the difference between what you intended to do and what actually happened. Well, look at climate change. When I do something to the climate, like burn a pile of leaves, I don't see any impact. I don't see any result. Because first of all, what I'm doing is just fairly relatively small compared to the planet. And second of all, even if it was big, it takes a long time for the result to be felt. So pollution isn't something that's immediately obvious. It takes decades. And what you are doing doesn't seem to be making a difference. So there's a huge amount of time between the action and the result. And that's true of a lot of things that we've had trouble stopping. Cigarette smoking, which is dangerous, leads to cancer of the lungs. When you smoke one cigarette, you feel good. You don't feel bad. And the impact, the negative impact, might come 20 or 30 years later. It's very hard to have a causal chain to understand it. That's one problem. Second of all, many systems have more than one feedback loop. When I do something, it impacts that, and that impacts that, and that impacts that, and that comes back, it impacts me. Well, gee, I can't follow all those loops. I'm not even aware of them. And also, they may be nonlinear. They may not make any difference for a while, and then as soon as the amount crosses some threshold, suddenly there's a big change. We're not used to that either. So we simply have real trouble understanding the powerful impact of feedback loops. Feedback, feed forward. Linearity, long delays in what is happening. And that makes trying to understand these complex systems like hunger, like clean water, like even for that matter, the impact of education. When I start teaching a child, educating a child, the real impact of that isn't felt for 20 years, perhaps. So that makes working with systems very, very complex, very, very difficult for people even to understand the nature of the system and to fit into the way that people are normally built, which is to for immediate causes and results.